In this illustration, we'll discuss about a situation when an image is produced on an object. Here, we are given that a thin equiconvex lens with refractive index 3/2 is placed on a horizontal mirror, as we can see here. And the space between lens and mirror is filled with the water. Here you can see, we are given that this space is filled with water. And when a point object is placed 15 cm above the lens on its principal axis, its image coincides with the object. And on repeating with another liquid instead of water, image coincides with object when it is at a distance 25 cm from the lens. So, we are required to find the refractive index of the lens. Now, in this situation here, we can see first when water is filled in it. This water lens can be considered as a plano convex lens, and these two lenses with the plane mirror can be considered as a single combination. So, here if we consider R is the radius of curvature of this lens, so we can write the focal length of lens is, this focal length can be written as F1. And this we can write as R by twice of mu minus 1, because this is an equiconvex lens. Here we substitute the value of mu as 3/2. This will be R upon twice of 3/2 minus 1. So, the value of focal length is equal to radius of curvature. And if we calculate the focal length of water lens, say this is F2, then this can be written as, it is a plano concave lens, so this can be written as R by mu water minus 1. And the mu of water is given as 4/3. So here we can write as R upon 4/3 minus 1, that is 1/3, it is equals to 3R. And if we calculate the focal length of the liquid lens, which is replaced instead of water, in second case, then the focal length of this liquid lens F3 can again be written as R by mu of liquid minus 1. This can be as it is taken. Now, we are given that when water is there, the image is produced on object when it is placed at a distance 15 cm above. And we know in case of an equivalent mirror, when object is placed at twice the focal length position or at center of curvature, its image coincides. So, here we can say in first case, equivalent focal length is, this should be 15/2, that is equals to 7.5 cm. Then this implies for combination, here we can write 1/F equivalent is equals to, this will be twice of F1 plus twice of F2, and as a mirror is a plane mirror, we can take focal length of mirror is equals to infinity in this situation. So, here we can write 1/7.5 is equals to, this first lens is a converging lens, so its focal length R can be taken as positive. So, this is 2/R, but for the second lens as being a plano concave lens, its focal length we take as negative, so this will be -2/3R, which is equals to here 4/3R, which implies the value of R is equals to 10 cm. So, we have got the radius of curvature of every surface in the system for the lens. And here, if in second case we analyze the same situation, then we can see in second case, with the liquid, we can write the focal length, equivalent focal length is, here it is given as 25 cm as 2F, so this will be 25/2, that is equals to 12.5 cm. So again, for combination here, we can use 1/12.5 is equals to 2/, the first radius is R, that can be taken as 10 cm, minus the second one is 2/F, the focal length can be taken as R by mu L minus 1, so this will be 2/10 multiplied by mu of liquid minus 1. we further simplify this, it will give us 1 by 12.5 is equals to this 2 by 10 multiplied by, we take this common, this 2 minus mu l. And further, if we simplify this here, we can see this will be 10 is equals to 25 multiplied by 2 minus mu l. So, on simplifying the value of mu l, we are getting is 8 by 5. That is the final result of this problem.